We are looking at part two.
今天我们看第二部分。
Last week, this was the first part that we looked at together.
上星期这是我们所看的。
Why do we study the book of Joel?
为什么我们要查约珥书?
So there are many 5-6 reasons that we have given. Why do we study the book of Joel?
所以我们有几个原因告诉我们为什么我们要查约珥书。
It is an important book.
因为它是很重要的。
Peter quoted this book when there was a Pentecost on Pentecost Sunday.
Peter在五旬节的星期日引用了这个经章。Right,
last Sunday was Pentecost Sunday, and Peter stood up instead of all the other prophetic books. He quoted the book of Joel.
Peter在五旬节的时候，他站起来，他引用的就是这一本。
So there are many other reasons.
还有其他的原因。
Secondly, we also look at this book. How interesting it is that we do not know much about the author or the prophet.
所以这里我们不知道他的作者，他的先知是谁。
We know the prophet, but we know very little.
我们知道他的先知，但是知道的很少。
The obscurity of the prophet.
这先知的身份是模糊的。
And then we move on to the first message that Joel preached.
然后我们看约珥他所传讲的第一个信息。
The importance, we looked at these 4 points.
它的重要性就是有这四点。
Number one, we must truly take time to hear and to give ear.
第一，我们要花时间好好的听，侧耳而听。
Not just we have been talking a lot, but do we take time to be still and to hear?
不只是说很多的话，而是要花时间安静来听。
Secondly, we looked at how the prophet say, you know, in the end times, when these things happen, these are unprecedented times.
第二先知说，当这些事情发生的时候，是空前的，是空前无有的。
So we have never seen these times, we have never experienced these times before.
我们从来没有经历过这样的时刻。
Even if you ask our fathers, they have not seen these things before.
即使你问我们的祖先，他们也未曾见过今天所发生的事情。
Thirdly, it's a message to the elders and to the leaders.
第三，他的信息是给长老和领袖的。
Because when we do that, the inhabitants will obey.
因为当我们遵守了，那其余的就会顺服。
And lastly, we look at how important it is to declare and proclaim this end times message.
最后我们看到这是多么的重要，要宣告这个末日的信息。
What is being said in the book of Revelation?
在启示录所说的。
And what is being said in this book of Joel?
还有在约珥书所传讲的。
How we need to teach one generation after another generation.
我们需要仔细的教导我们一代传于另一代。
If you realize the context of what we are looking at,
如果你发觉到我们所看的内容,
so at that time, after all these things, I just briefly tell you that the people of Israelites, they repented.
以色列百姓当他们悔改之后,
then they have a good king. King Josiah came and did all the reforms.
他们有一个很好的王，就是约西亚王，他就来。 来做这个改革。
And then you have Prophet Jeremiah, who still continued to prophesy warning of the impending judgment to come to the nation.
然后还有这个耶利米先知，他还是在那里警告他们这一个将来临的审判。
Why? People will be thinking, hey, they have repented, we have a good king. Prophet Joel have spoken about all this. Why do you need to keep warning?
然后那些百姓可能就会说，为什么呢？都已经他们已经有这么好的王，为什么这个先知要一直的在那里警告他们？
But interestingly, or very sadly, after King Josiah died,
很悲惨的就是当约西亚王他过世之后，
very quickly the people of Israel went back to idolatry.
很快的，以色列百姓又回去拜偶像。
And not long after that,
而在这不久之前，
there was an invasion of the enemy on their land.
不久之后就有仇敌来侵略他们的土地。
But what did Prophet Joel say?
但是约珥先知做什么呢？
The Prophet Joel asked the people to teach one generation to another generation to another generation.
约珥先知叫他们要一代传于另一代。
Because people is easy for people to forget.
因为人很容易会忘记。
And then it's easy for the next generation to rise up and become mock and scoff at what used to happen in the previous generation.
因为下一代的人，他们很容易就会起来嘲笑、讥讽上一代的人他们所经历的事情。
It's a very real thing for people to quickly forget about the righteousness of God and the judgments of God.
这是很悲惨的, 因为人很容易的就会忘记神的公义和审判。
And then very quickly, they turn and they backslide, they become indifferent, they begin to scoff, they begin to mock.
人很快就会堕落, 然后背叛神, 就开始讥讽神, 嘲笑神。
In order to avoid all that,
为了避免这些事情,
the biblical teaching has always to be, you need to keep passing on the message to the next generation.
圣经的教导就是我们总要把主的信息传给下一代。
What God speaks, we must deliver faithfully to the next generation.
主跟我们说什么, 我们就要忠实地传与下一代。
We cannot sugarcoat it, we cannot just choose, pick and choose what to deliver just to make the people happy.
我们不可以把神的信息包上糖果, 只是为了要使人觉得很听了很开心很爽, 然后就给他们这个糖果的信息。
So we need to look at this, we will look at this towards the end of the session.
所以到最终的时候, 我们要看这个,
tonight,
今晚,
but tonight we are going to have a very short and a very quick study because we are only going to look at one verse.
今晚我们的查经会简短的, 而且是很快的, 因为我们会看的只是一个经节。
Last week we have seen Joel chapter 1 verses 1 to 3.
上星期我们看约珥书一章一到三节。
Tonight we are going to look at verse 4.
今天我们要看的是第四节。
Verse 4 talks about all the locusts and all that.
第四节说到的是各样的蝗虫。
Before going to verse 4 itself,
在去到第四节之前,
I want to look at a few things in the Old Testament to give us a background for understanding locusts.
让我们看旧约的几个经节, 使我们明白这个蝗虫。
Locust is often mentioned in the Bible.
蝗虫在圣经里面总是被提到,
especially in the Old Testament.
特别是在旧约,
so we must understand.
所以我们必须理解,
when Prophet Joel talked about locusts,
当约珥先知说到这个蝗虫,
there is a meaning, there is a context, there is a background to it.
它是有它的意思, 它的内容和背景的。
Basically, before going to the verses, if you see on the screen, these are locusts. Locusts are like grasshopper, a type of grasshopper, locusts. And it can consume food that is of the same weight of its body.
蝗虫就好像一种的蚱蜢, 它可以吞吃那个食物和它一样大的分量的食物。
And then, within hours, one great swarm of locusts can destroy a great harvest.
在一个小时之内,
a few hours,
几小时之内, 一大堆的蝗虫就能够毁坏整个,
We may not be very familiar with this, but these things happen very much in the Middle East.
我们对这种蝗虫好像不大熟悉, 但是它在中东是很普遍的。
It includes places like even India, Africa. These things are very real.
在印度、非洲这些的蝗虫的灾害是很真实的。
Even 2 years ago, there was during pandemic, there was a great swarm of locusts that attacked the plantation.
即使在两年前也有这个蝗虫攻击庄稼。
If you look at the next slide, you will see the brown or gray color is like a swarm of locusts that they are getting ready to come and attack the plantation.
你看后面那个灰色可色在空中的, 他们就是预备好来 飞过来攻击这一些的庄稼。
The farmer was watching helplessly, not knowing what to do with this coming locust swarm.
那个农夫就是无助地看着这一大堆的蝗虫飞来, 不知道该做什么。
If the swarm of locusts is really great,
如果这个蝗虫是那么多, 那么大,
it can even block the sunlight.
它的灾害甚至它能够挡住太阳。
To the extent it can make the place a very dark place.
使到整个地区变成是灰暗的。
So you can see in the picture, it's a scary thing.
你看在图画面上,这是可怕的灾害。
So what does the Bible speak concerning locusts?
所以圣经对蝗虫有什么说法呢?
Firstly, let's look at one of the 10 plagues in the book of Exodus.
让我们看首先出埃及记,
the 8th,
其中一个十灾,
the plague number 8.
第八灾。
Let me read from Exodus 10, verses 4 to 6.
出埃及记十章四到六节。
Or else, this is Moses and Aaron speaking to Pharaoh, if you refuse to let my people go, Behold, tomorrow I will bring locusts into your territory, and they shall cover the face of the earth so that no one will be able to see the earth. They shall eat the residue of what is left, which remains to you from the hail. They shall eat every tree which grows up for you out of the field. They shall fill your houses, houses of all your servants, and houses of all the Egyptians, which neither your fathers nor your father's father have seen since the day they were on the earth to this day. And he turned and went out from Pharaoh.
你若不肯容我的百姓去，明天我要使蝗虫进入你的境内，遮满地面，甚至看不见地，并且吃那冰泡所剩的和田间所长的一切树木，你的宫殿和你众臣仆的房屋，以及一切埃及人的房屋都要被蝗虫占满了。自从你祖宗和你祖宗的祖宗在世以来，直到今日，没有见过这样的灾。摩西就转身离开法老出去。
If we read the verses just now, it says it covers the face of the earth until you can't see.
所以刚才的经节说，它遮盖全地，甚至看不见地面。
And this is so bad that the locust not only attack the plants and the trees, it goes into the room.
这个是那么的糟糕，因为它不只是吞吃植物，它还进入房屋。
Right? In this plague, Moses told Pharaoh, all these locusts will swarm the houses, fill your houses.
在这个蝗虫之灾，摩西告诉法老说：“这一些的蝗虫，他们会充满你的屋子。”That
they have never seen before. Moses said, "Not your father nor your father's father's death. This is again an unprecedented event."
摩西说：“是你的祖宗祖宗所未曾见过的，这也是一个空前无有的事情。”Brothers
and sisters, what is this about?
弟兄姐妹，这是关于什么呢？
Very clearly. 10 plagues speaks about judgment.
很清楚的实灾就是神的审判。
And one of the judgments that was released by God was by releasing the plague of locusts.
就是把那个蝗虫释放出来。
But let's study this carefully.
让我们仔细地查。
It was a judgment against the oppressors of God's people.
这是一个审判来审判那一些
Am I right? Moses and Aaron went to Pharaoh.
是吗? 摩西和亚伦去找法老。
And said, let my people go.
说让我的百姓离开。
Say, God said, let my people go.
他们说神说让我的百姓离开。
Each time he refused,
每一次他拒绝,
God hardened his heart.
神就刚硬法老的心。
God displayed his power by releasing judgment on them.
神就释放审判在他们的身上。 就来显示他的大能。
Originally, if we can see from this story,
如果我们能够从这故事看见,
originally, this judgment is meant for the enemies of God's people.
原本上这个审判本是要赐给神的仇敌的。
It's not meant to affect the people of God.
并不是用来影响神的百姓的。
But it is something God displayed his power when he released judgment to let the Pharaoh and the Egyptians know who he is.
神彰显他的大能, 借着这一些的审判来让这些埃及人知道他是谁。
So it was a scary thing for them.
所以这对他们是一个可怕的事情。
And after we look at this account in the book of Exodus,
当我们看这个出埃及记的记载之后,
later on, after the Israelites have came out from Egypt,
当以色列人从埃及出来之后,
God began to, then we know, as we learn on Sunday, God met them at Mount Sinai.
神就在西乃山与他们相遇。
God began to release his Torah, his laws, and his commandments.
在那里释放他的律法，他的十诫给他们。
And then God entered into a covenant with his people.
神就与他的百姓进入一个约立约。
He said, if you obey me, if you listen to me, obey me, I will be your God, you will be my people.
他说如果你顺服我，我就做你的神。 你们就做我的百姓,
it will be my treasured possession.
就做我珍贵的财宝。
It was an invitation for them to enter into this covenant.
这是一个给他们的邀请来进入这个约。
God initiated this covenant.
神主动这个约。
Because he loved them.
因为神爱他们。
And he said, come, let's enter into a covenant.
而他说, 来, 让我们进入这个约。
If you obey me,
如果你顺服我,
I will bless you based on this covenant.
我就按照这些约来祝福你。
But many people just focus on the blessing.
但很多人只是专注在那个祝福。
At the same time, this covenantal relationship also speaks about things that will happen when they disobey.
同时呢, 这个立约性的关系也是 关系到如果他们不顺服的时候, 就会有什么事情发生?
So the famous chapter in Deuteronomy chapter 28.
所以生命记28章很出名的一章,
blessings when you obey.
就是当你顺服的时候, 你拥有的祝福,
and curses when you disobey.
还有你不顺服的时候, 你带来的咒诅,
so if you read that portion on blessing, you like it very much.
所以当你读那祝福的部分, 你很喜欢,
or we can quote it, we can memorize it, we can make it into our prayer.
你把它引用起来, 背起来, 祷告,
bless my coming in, my going out, you'll bless my farm, my barns and all that.
祝福我的进和处, 祝福我的仓库等等。
But when we go down to the curses,
可是当你去到咒诅那一部分,
what was first intended for the oppressors of God's people?
本来这些咒诅是给那个欺压神百姓的敌人的。
But because of this covenantal relationship,
但是因着这种立约的关系,
God say, if you disobey me,
神说, 如果你不顺服,
one of the curses is this locust will also come and attack you.
在那个咒诅的其中一个就是这个蝗虫也会转过来攻击你。
So there are many curses.
所以有许多的咒诅。
Let's look at this when it mentioned about locusts.
让我们来看当他提到蝗虫。
Deuteronomy chapter
28,
verses 38 to 42.
38到42节,
you shall carry much seed out to the field, but gather little in, for the locust shall consume it. You shall plant vineyards and tend them, but you shall neither drink of the wine nor gather the grapes, for the worms shall eat them. You shall have olive trees throughout all your territory, but you shall not anoint yourself with the oil, for your olives shall drop off. You shall beget sons and daughters, but they shall not be yours, for they shall go into captivity. Locusts shall consume all your trees and the produce of your land.
你带到田间的种子虽多，收进来的却少，因为被蝗虫吃了。你栽种修理葡萄园，却不得收葡萄，也不得喝葡萄酒，因为被虫子吃了。 你全景有橄榄树，却不得其油麻生，因为树上的橄榄不熟，自落了。你生儿养女，却不算是你的，因为必被掳去。你所有的树木和你地里的出产，必被蝗虫所吃。
So you see in verse 38, it says locusts shall consume when you, even though you sow much seed, you will reap very little.
所以你看38节，他说，即使你撒种多，收的却少。
And then in verse 42, the locusts shall eat up all the trees, the produce of your land.
42节说,蝗虫必吃尽了你土里的出产。
So what was meant for the enemy now is also becoming a curse to God's people if they disobey.
所以本来这些是给仇敌的,但是因着神的百姓不顺服,它就成了他们的咒诅。
Let's think for a moment.
让我们来想,
when locusts eat up the seed,
当蝗虫吃掉那个种子,
when locusts eat up the plants,
当蝗虫吃掉那植物,
and the trees,
还有树木,
what happens?
会发生什么事呢?
These will create an agricultural crisis.
这就会产生这个农业上的危机。
What kind of crisis is this?
什么样的危机呢?
This crisis will lead to famine.
这样的危机就会产生饥荒。
Food shortage.
食物短缺。
Something that today, many news that we read today speak about famine.
好像今天我们所读的很多的新闻告诉我们饥荒。
Or food shortage.
食物短缺。
So food shortages can be caused by many factors.
你看食物短缺可以因着很多因素的发生。
Maybe some is supply chain. No, the supply chain, that means there is no transportation.
有些是供应链被干扰，就是没有交通。
Or sometimes it can be caused by people don't want to sell, people don't want to export.
或者是人不要卖出去，不要把它运出去。
And there is also the possibility of locusts eating up the crops.
还有另一个可能性就是有蝗虫把那些农作物都吃掉了。
So, at that point, when Joel prophesied this, Israel was going through an agricultural crisis, a very huge famine.
所以当这个约珥先知他预言这件事的时候, 以色列百姓正在经历农业上的危机，也就是饥荒。
These things will not stop there. It will escalate to become the invasion of enemy into their land.
这些东西还不会停在那里，它还会继续直到仇敌入侵他们的土地。
So many people, many Christians will say, okay, well, these are the curses. under the law.
然后很多基督徒就会说，哦，这些是在律法之下的咒诅。
So when Jesus died on the cross, he has broken every curse on the law.
然后耶稣为我们死在十字架上的时候，他已经破除了所有的咒诅。
That is true.
这也是真实的。
When Jesus died on the cross,
但耶稣死在十字架上,
every curse of the law has been broken.
所有律法的咒诅已经破除了。
But then my question is, does it mean we can now disobey?
那我的问题就是，那么是不是代表我们现在就可以不顺服神呢？
Does it mean if we disobey, oh, it's been taken care of by the cross, I can do what I want?
是不是说我们可以随便就不顺服，因为我们的罪已经被十字架上对付了，我们要做什么都可以。
And then it will not attract any consequence if I disobey.
如果我不顺服，就不会带来什么不好的后果。
So this is one of the themes that we will carefully look at in this book.
所以这就是在这本书我们要仔细看的。
Because many people say, no more judgments, you do what you want, no, nothing will happen.
因为很多人说,喜欢说,再也没有审判了,你要做什么就去做吧,不会有事情发生的。
Let us not be deceived.
让我们不要自欺。
The Bible also speaks of a great white throne of judgment in the book of Revelation.
因为圣经在启示录告诉我们有神摆设的审判大宝座。
And repeatedly in the book of Revelation, we are told, we will be judged according to our works.
重复性的在启示录神告诉我们说，我们会按着我们的作为被审判。
Of course, if our name is in the book of life, that speaks about salvation.
当然，我们的名字如果是在生命册上，那是说到我们的救恩。
Our salvation is not based on works.
我们的救恩不是靠行为。
It's based on grace and grace alone.
是单单靠着神的恩典。
But does not mean we can do what we want.
但这并不代表说我们可以随心所欲。
And does not mean that once our name is in the book of life, it will be there forever.
这也不代表说如果我们的名字在生命册上就会永远在那里。
Because in the book of Revelation, we saw how it says, even your name can be removed from the book of life.
因为启示录告诉我们说，即使是你的在生命册上，你的名字也可以从那里被除掉的。
So the theology of once saved, always saved, is not biblical.
所以那个神学一次得救永远得救是不合乎圣经的。
So it's very important when we read Joel, we begin to understand.
所以当我们读约珥书的时候，我们就要开始理解。
Judgment is both Old Testament and New Testament. So it is still a relevant theme.
审判同时是旧约和新约，它是两个都是重要的主题。
It's not that after in the New Testament suddenly poof, no more judgment.
并不是说到了新约，然后审判就完全不用了。
So very clearly, we see what was meant for the oppressors of God's people now, it became a curse for disobedience.
所以这里清楚地告诉我们说，本来这些咒诅是给那欺压神百姓的，但是因着我们的不顺服，它转到我们身上。
But doesn't mean that God does this to make us suffer.
但并不是代表说神做这些事来叫我们受苦。
The Bible, we are told when God releases judgment, it is to teach people righteousness.
圣经告诉我们说，当神释放审判，是为了教导我们公义。
And when these things happen,
然后当这些事情发生,
God even gives promise.
神还赐给我们应许。
It says, when these things happen, remember when King Solomon dedicated the temple.
神说当这些事情发生, 你记得当所罗门他献上圣殿的时候,
yeah, we have read that in the beginning of this year.
在今年的年初我们读到,
we have seen how when King Solomon dedicated the temple, King Solomon prayed to God and God gave him a promise.
当所罗门王他献上圣殿的时候，他向神祷告，神就赐给他一个应许。
God said, I will put my name in this temple.
神说我要把我的名字放在这殿里。
And when people pray from this place,
当百姓从这里祷告,
I will hear them.
我就要听。
That's why we read in Book of Chronicles when King Jehoshaphat stood before God with all the people.
所以在生命记,
Chronicles. Because King Jehoshaphat together with the people, they claim the promise of God. Let's look at the promise given to King Solomon.
2
Chronicles chapter 7.
列代志下第七,
we know about verse 14.
我们知道第14节,
very famous.
很出名的,
but let's look at the background to it.
I
read from verse 12.
12节,
then the Lord appeared to Solomon by night and said to him, I have heard your prayer and have chosen this place for myself as a house of sacrifice. When I shut up heaven and there is no rain, or command the locusts to devour the land, or send pestilence among my people, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, pray and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven, will forgive their sin, and heal their land. Now my eyes will be open, my ears attentive to prayer made in this place. For now I have chosen and sanctified this house, that my name may be there forever, and my eyes and my heart will be there perpetually.
夜间耶和华向所罗门显现对他说，我已经听了你的祷告，也选择这地方作为祭祀我的殿宇。 我若使天必塞不下雨，或此蝗虫吃这地的出产，出产或是瘟疫流行在我民中，这称为我名下的子民，若是自卑祷告，寻求我的面，转离他们的恶行，我必从天上垂听，赦免他们的罪，医治他们的地。我必睁眼看，侧耳听，在此处所献的祷告。
So we like verse 14. So we quote the promise.
We
talk about it. My people call by my name, humble themselves, pray, seek my face, turn from wicked ways, I will hear from heaven.
God
will forgive our sin, God will heal our land. Then we must first know what is the sickness in the land.
但你要知道,
what is the sickness?
那地的疾病是什么?
God himself told Solomon.
就是神告诉所罗门,
God himself can shut up the heaven.
神可以使把天闭塞起来,
that there is no rain.
使它不下雨,
so that the agriculture field will suffer.
然后这些农作物呢,
no food.
没有食物吃,
it's a judgment.
是一个审判,
it's a discipline.
是一个管教,
and what can happen next? God can command locusts to eat up the land.
神还能够吩咐蝗虫把这个地的农作物给吃掉了。
And what can happen next?
接下来呢?
God can send pestilence among his people.
神还能够使瘟疫流行在他的百姓当中。
Do you see? It can come from God.
这些可以从神来的。
It is the Bible.
这是在圣经里的。
It says these things can happen because my people have sinned against me.
神说, 这些事情可以发生在他们身上，因为我的百姓得罪我。
But yet, even when these things happen,
但即使有这些事情发生,
I still provide a way out.
我还是给他们一条出路。
It doesn't mean I will make them suffer and then die and have no hope.
这并不代表我要叫他们受苦，然后死了，然后没有盼望。
It is telling them, hey, you need to know when this happens, you come to this temple, I put my name, you pray, I can answer.
神是在告诉他们说，当这些事情发生的时候，你要来到这殿自卑悔改祷告，我必垂听。
You have to repent.
你要来悔改。
You have to fulfill the requirement.
来成就这个条件。
Turn from your wicked ways.
转离你的恶行。
So this is the full message.
所以这是完整的信息。
Not just all the time, God will bless you, nothing bad will happen.
不只是一直都是神会祝福你，什么事情都不会发生。 不是的,
and if something bad happens, it must be the devil.
而如果有什么事情发生，一定是魔鬼。
Here we read, it is God himself who shut the heaven.
这里告诉我们神会把天给闭塞起来。
God can send locusts.
神能够差遣蝗虫。
God can send pestilence.
神能够允许差遣这个瘟疫。
Of course, there are those that are permitted by God, which are the works of the devil, true.
当然,这些实在是魔鬼的作为,但是神允许他。
Right? God can allow some of the demonic activities within his wisdom and within his great sovereign power.
神在他的智慧和大能的掌权里,他可以允许某一些的邪灵执行他们的活动。
And of course, he also will abide by the spiritual principle.
而且神还会居住在守住这个属灵的定律。
That means if a child of God
就是说如果神的孩子
opens up the door,
他自己开门,
invites the devil,
邀请魔鬼进来,
God, it is his free will to open the door.
这个孩子的自由意志, 他打开门给魔鬼的。
If a Christian reads horoscope.
如果一个基督徒喜欢读那些星座,
oh, what will happen and all that? You are opening up the door for demons to attack you.
会发生什么事？这个那个，你就是自己打开这个门给魔鬼进来攻击你。
And then you don't blame the devil.
那你就不要埋怨魔鬼。
The way to be saved is to repent.
要得救的方式就是你要悔改。
Close the door.
关闭这个门。
Don't do this again.
不要再做这些事。
Repent.
要悔改。
So this is just one example.
这是其中一个例子。
So we read from the Bible in 2 Chronicles that there is a way out when locusts is sent by God.
所以历代之下告诉我们说，当有这个蝗虫从神那里差遣出来的时候，神开了一条出路。
Isn't it an eye-opener that the verse we read just now, it says God can even send pestilence.
这是不是令你大开眼界呢？因为刚才这一句话说神可以差遣瘟疫。
You see, when we say that God can send it, God can use different agents to send it.
当我们说神差来，也就是说神可以使用不同的different
sources,
不同的源头来差来。
May allow the wicked people to do something.
神会允许某一些邪恶的人来做一些事。
But God permits it to happen.
神允许它发生。
It is part of God's disciplining God's judgment.
这是神其中一部分的他的审判，他的管教。
So we have seen the background.
所以我们已经看了他的背景。
The biblical understanding of locusts, right?
圣经的理解关于这个蝗虫。
Even when judgment comes,
即使当审判临到,
we can pray and reverse the judgment.
我们还是可以祷告扭转这个审判。
Later on in the chapter, later on in this book, you will still see, hey, God can restore. God can bring restoration.
那等一下你可以看到神还可以带来恢复。
So this book of Joel is a very complete book, tells us the both facets of God.
所以这个约珥书是很完整的一本书，告诉我们神的两面。
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's now zoom in to verse 4, what we're going to read tonight.
所以让我们现在仔细看约珥书第一章第四节。
Let's read verse 4. What the chewing locust left, the swarming locust has eaten. What the swarming locust left, the crawling locust has eaten. And what crawling locust left, the consuming locust has eaten.
捡从剩下的蝗虫来吃，蝗虫剩下的 男子来吃，男子剩下的马蚱来吃。
So these original words, it's a bit difficult to translate.
这原意是很难翻译的。
It may talk about four different types of locusts.
它可能说到四种不同的蝗虫。
And these are different locusts and they are not related together.
这些不同的蝗虫是彼此没有关系的。
And like what we read in the other scriptures just now, locusts are generally spoken in the Bible.
就好像我们所读到的这个蝗虫在圣经普遍上都提到。
Not only here in the book of Judges, Nahum, Isaiah, Jeremiah, references to locusts have always been made.
不只是在这里，在拿鸿书、四世纪各处都是有提到这个蝗虫。
And here, some translations say they name the locust, some translation, they use the root word and describe the locust.
有些翻译版本，它使用它的根源的字来形容它的蝗虫。
If you look here,
如果你看这里,
some people, they name the four different locusts, palmer worm, locust, canker worm, caterpillar. They use different types of names for the locust.
它就用不同的名字来形容这里所说的蝗虫。
Four types of locusts.
四种。
But other translations,
其中的版本呢?
They use the verb, the feature of that locust. Some, the first type is the chewing type.
他们用它的特性，比如说第一种的是会吞吃的。
Chewing type, the second type is the swarming type.
第二种的是一群的。
The third type is the crawling type.
第三种呢是爬行的。
Right, and the last one is the consuming type.
最后的是一种完全的吃尽的。
Similarly, you can see at the second row there, the different English words being used in other translations.
所以你可以在那里第二段看到在不同的版本他们也用不同的字眼。
But it carries the same similar meanings.
但它带着同样的相同的意思。
Chewing and gnawing is about the same.
咀嚼的是差不多一样。
Swarming, we know it comes in a group.
一群的。
And then creeping and crawling is almost the same.
爬行的差不多.
Or stripping, they strip you or they eat up the tree is almost the same.
或者是把它给吞吃掉的,
number one, we must know that these are four waves of locusts.
这是蝗虫的四波.
Imagine one wave of, just now we saw the picture of the swarm of locusts, one wave come eat up.
你看刚才我们看那个蝗虫的画面, 就是第一波来, 它那个蝗虫把它吃掉.
Maybe still left some in some plants not eaten up.
然后可能有剩下一些植物没有被吃掉.
Another wave of locusts come.
然后第二波的蝗虫又来吃掉了.
Left a bit more, another wave flower.
然后剩下一点点, 又另一波的蝗虫又来吃.
And finally, the fourth wave of locusts come and clear up everything.
最后第四波的蝗虫来把所有的一切都吃尽了.
Brothers and sisters,
弟兄姐妹,
we cannot expect the devil, the enemy, to be nice to God's people.
你不能够期待神的仇敌对神的百姓很良善.
We cannot expect compassion from God's enemy, from the devil, the adversary.
你不能够期待神的仇敌魔鬼对你有怜悯的心.
We always think, "Aiya, maybe devil will pity me, won't hit me so hard."
我们时常以为说, "Aiya, 可能魔鬼会可怜我, 然后不会对我那么下手那么重."
John chapter 10 verse 10.
约翰福音十章十节.
The enemy comes to steal.
告诉我们仇敌是来偷窃.
After stealing, he won't stop.
偷完之后他不会停止.
He moved on to something worse. He will kill.
他还要来杀害.
And ultimately is to destroy.
然后最终呢他就来毁灭.
If he can steal your dream,
如果他能来偷窃你的梦,
he will kill whatever hope that is in you.
他就来杀死你里面所有的盼望.
And ultimately destroy the destiny God has for you.
最终来毁灭神给你的天命.
Even though we see all these four different locusts,
其实我们看到这四种不同的,
but
蝗虫,
you can see the four waves of increasing intensity.
你可以看到这四波逐渐增加的,
of increasing terribleness.
可怕, 逐渐增加的可怕, 恐怖.
To steal, to kill, to destroy.
他首先来偷, 然后来杀害, 然后来毁灭.
This is also a picture of the end time.
这也是末日的画面.
Remember Matthew 24.
你记得马太福音24章?
Birth pangs.
有这个惨痛.
Beginning of sorrows.
患难的起头.
We have said, you know, when the pandemic of COVID-19 happened.
我们说过当这个 COVID-19, 这个新冠肺炎发生的时候,
it is like a beginning of sorrow, it's a birth pang.
它是好像惨痛, 患难的起头.
People want to go back to normalcy very fast.
人很快地想要回到, 普通的生活里面.
Everybody wants that, not wrong.
每个人都在等, 这不是错的.
But unknowingly, very quickly, it can lead to the next thing, to the next thing.
但却不知道很快的这第一个就引领到第二个第三个.
Like there are four, like this locust, there are four waves.
好像这蝗虫它有四波.
So birth pangs will increase in frequency and intensity.
所以那个惨痛会逐渐的增加，更越来越多，而且越来越激烈.
We must know this.
我们必须知道.
We cannot stuck our head and bury it under the sand.
我们不可以把头埋在沙里.
We must discern.
我们必须要分辨.
Look at the increasing wickedness.
你看那邪恶的增加.
Look at the increasing troubles and turmoils on the earth.
你看在全地增加性的问题和痛苦.
We are not without hope.
我们并不是没有盼望的人.
We are people with the word of God. We know what to do. We can be ready, we can prepare.
我们带着神的话语, 我们知道该怎么做, 我们应该预备好.
And we can be God's blessing to others when things become darker.
当事情变得越来越黑暗的时候, 我们可以成为神给别人的祝福.
If we position ourselves properly,
如果我们好好地摆正自己的岗位,
we prepare ourselves well,
如果我们预备好自己.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, we look at these four types of locusts. Very quickly, I also want to run through them. And we can learn something about this. It is also describing to us how the enemy come and invade our life.
这里也向我们形容仇敌是怎么样来侵略我们的生命的。
Let's look at the first one.
让我们看第一个。
See the chewing locust.
你看这个咀嚼的蝗虫。
This from learning by learning at these qualities, we also can identify what the enemies does their strategy in our lives.
这品质也告诉我们说，仇敌在我们的生命中的策略是怎么样。
So firstly, it comes to chew, to gnaw.
首先，它是来咀嚼、来吃、来咬。
To chew on our conscience.
来咀嚼我们的良心。
To make it numb.
使我们变得麻木。
It looks like a small thing.
看起来是小小的东西。
But this is the strategy by the enemy.
但这就是仇敌的策略。
It looks very, not a very big action.
它看起来是无害的，不是什么大的行动。
But it only chews. It just takes one bite at a time.
慢慢一次一口的咬。
How does this thing happen?
这是怎么发生的呢？
The enemy uses the things we listen to, we read, and we watch.
仇敌就使用我们所听的、所读的、所看的东西。
Innocent things.
看起来是无害的东西。
You keep reading it.
你一直去读。
It eats up your conscience. It bites and it chews your conscience.
它就吃、咀嚼掉你的良心。
This first type of locust.
这第一种的蝗虫。
It acts on our appetite and desires.
是看我们的渴慕、我们的胃口是什么。
It knows. It has been studying human nature for thousands of years.
它已经研读了人的历史几千年。
So it will present itself as something palatable to your appetite.
它会呈现一些看起来是非常符合你胃口的。
You would like to watch something, it will let you watch that movie.
你喜欢看什么，它就会让你看那个电影。
And inside the movie, they will inject some message there to chew on our conscience.
而在那个电影里面，他就偷偷放入一些的信息来吞噬你的良心。
To influence us.
来影响我们。
See, chewing is small bite.
你看，咀嚼是小虫子的咀嚼，小小的一口一口。
So it comes through influence. It doesn't come through direct contact. It influences what you read, what you hear, what you watch.
它透过影响进来的，它不是直接来对付你的，它透过你听什么、看什么、读什么。
Little things that it drops into your mind.
小小的一个概念，它放进你的思想里。
So you, brothers and sisters, we must be very careful. This first type of locust, even though looks innocent, but very deadly.
所以弟兄姐妹，你要小心这种蝗虫。看起来它好像无害的，但却是致命的。
These are the things that are that will look very innocent. Everybody is doing it. Everybody is watching it. Why I can't do it?
它看起来是无害的，每个人都在读，每个人都在看，为什么我不可以？
Through one drop of the seed inside your mind.
透过一点的这个种子在你的思想里。
The thought of rebellion.
这个悖逆的思想。
The thought of lust.
情欲的思想。
The thought of envy.
妒忌的思想。
And slowly eating up our conscience.
慢慢一口一口的咬你的良心。
This influence can come through just a thought or maybe a conversation or maybe a movie or a lyrics of a music.
You've
got to watch and have doors in our ear gate, our eye gate. All these gates must be in place.
你必须要小心探索你的耳门，你的眼门全部都要守好。
You must make a strong decision. I'm not going to allow this to come in and bite at my conscience.
你必须要做很强烈的决定，就是你不会允许这些东西进来吞噬你的良心。
You gotta watch our desires, our appetite.
你要小心的监察你自己的胃口和你的渴望。
So this is how it works, little by little.
所以它是这样子进行的，一点一点来。
If left unchecked,
如果你没有去查看,
you do not know that it has already numbed your senses.
你不知道它已经使你的知觉麻木了。
You don't feel like reading the Bible anymore.
然后你就没有这个胃口想要读圣经。
You don't feel like praying anymore.
也不想要祷告。
You don't want to worship. You don't want to go to church.
不想要敬拜神，不想要上教会。
You don't know how it happened.
你不知道它是什么时候怎么发生的。
How is it that suddenly I lose interest in these things.
为什么突然间你对这些就失去了兴趣?
It doesn't happen suddenly.
它不是突然间发生的。
It chews one bite at a time.
它一个时候咬你一口。
Just one bite is all it takes.
它只需要咬一口。
So brothers and sisters, be careful. If you know something of God that has been chewed by the enemy, we have allowed the enemy to chew.
所以弟兄姐妹,你要小心,你要知道如果你的里面有什么东西,你允许仇敌来吞吃了。
We must quickly wake up.
你必须要赶快醒过来。
Quickly do something about it.
赶快起来做一些事情。
We pray, quickly look at 2 Chronicles 7 says, we must repent, come back to God.
赶快祷告,看历代志下,告诉你说,你要悔改,回到神那里。
If not, if we leave it unchecked, don't think that the devil will say, ah, I got my target, I leave him alone.
要不然如果你允许他继续的没有去监察他,你不要以为仇敌会放过你。
The next wave will come.
因为仇敌会带来第二波。
When it's able to make you numb.
当他已经能够使你变得麻木了。
You don't feel guilty doing wrong things.
你做错你也不觉得内疚了。
You think you try to justify yourself.
你还要为自己找借口,
you defend yourself for the things you do.
因着你所做的事情还要自己辩护。
You have opened the door for the next wave of locusts.
那你就打开门给下一波的蝗虫进来。
This is scary. This second wave is scary.
这是很可怕的, 这第二波。
Once he knows that he can chew on you,
当他知道他可以来咀嚼你,
he will come in one great group, a swarming locust.
第二波的时候, 他就一大群的来了。
See this one, right? First is chewing, gnawing.
你看第一波的时候, 他是在那里咀嚼。
Next one is swarming.
下一波的时候, 他一群的来。
When it comes as a swarm,
当他好像一群一样的来,
it begins to eat up more things.
它就来吞吃更多的东西。
Your energy, your vitality, your awakeness, all, because all these are big portions, it begins to eat up the bigger portions.
你的精力,你的
Your energy.
你的精力,
what is it just now I say? All these things, it begin to eat up the bigger portion.
这些更大部分的, 它就开始来吞吃更多了。
How you are awakened.
你的醒觉。
All these things are a major part of us.
这些都是我们里面很大的部分。
And it needs a swarming locust to begin to eat our vitality.
需要一群的蝗虫来吞吃我们里面重要的东西。
And when it comes as a swarm,
当它好像一群而来,
we will be, you see, like what we read just now, so when it comes as a swarm, it can cover up the land.
你看好像刚才我们所读的, 当它好像一群来的时候, 它可以遮满全地。
It blocks the light.
它拦阻了光。
What happens then?
然后发生什么事呢?
You will be confused.
你就会变得很混乱。
Because you can't see clearly anymore.
因为你看不清了。
The word of God cannot be a lamp, cannot do your food, cannot be a light to your path anymore.
神的话语不再能够成为你脚前的灯路上的光。
So because it comes as a swarm to block that light, block the entrance of God's truth into you.
因为它一群的来拦住了那个光的入口。
Because when your heart and conscience is numb,
因为当你的心, 你的良心是麻木的,
the enemy will grab the opportunity to block light from coming in.
仇敌就趁机抓住这个机会来拦阻任何光的入口,
to blind you.
使你瞎眼。
See, at this time, you can hear from God, you can understand, you don't receive live from the word of God.
在这时候你就听不到神，你也不能明白，你无法从神领受亮光。
Makes you commit even more wrong choices, more wrong actions, wrong decisions.
你里面就制造更多的问题，错误的决定，错误的选择。
So, brothers and sisters,
所以弟兄姐妹,
you don't think that small bite, nothing.
你不要以为那小小的咀嚼是没有问题的。
Small bite will lead to swarming locusts.
蝗虫小小小小一口一口的咀嚼，最会带来大群的蝗虫。
You know, locusts, there are two types. Some are solitary, some are swarming. They must act in a group.
你看蝗虫，有些是单独形式，有些是一群来的。
And when these swarming one, they talk to each other in a very special way. They come together. There's food here. All come. All will come.
这一群来的，他们是一起沟通好的。他们说这里有食物，他们就一群领到。
Food is finishing. Let's go another way. They'll go another way.
或者是有他的领袖说食物完了，我们去别处。他们就去别处。
And after they leave,
他们离开之后呢?
You thought that everything is okay?
你以为所有的事情都安好了?
Your door is wide open.
但是你的门是大大打开的。
Because you don't have the word of God.
因为你没有神的话语。
You're confused.
你是混乱的。
You're lost.
你是迷失的。
Many areas of your lives are now open and susceptible to the attack of the enemy.
你生命中许多的方面都已经向仇敌是敞开的。
You give permission to all kinds of demonic attacks.
你就允许各种各样的魔鬼性的攻击进来。
Look at this again. What is the third type?
你看第三种是什么?
They creep inside.
他们爬进来。
One at a time, different things begin to crawl and creep in.
一个一个的不同的东西开始爬进来。
You are somewhat now in a bondage.
现在你就是在捆绑中了。
Because you've opened up all the doors.
因为你一直来你的门都是打开的。
You are under the control of these locusts.
你就在这个蝗虫的邪灵的控制之下。
You begin to hear what it says. You begin to do what these locusts tell you to do.
你开始听这些蝗虫告诉你的话，他们叫你做什么，你就做什么。
Because they can creep in, they can creep out.
因为他们能自由地爬进爬出。They
can crawl in, crawl out.
爬进爬出。All
giving you direction.
给你各种各样的方向。
You are now under the control of this Beelzebub, the Lord of the flies.
你现在是在这个魔鬼。 这个苍蝇的王的魔鬼之下。
See the, in the Bible, the devil himself is described as the Lord of the flies.
你看在圣经里面，那个魔鬼是被形容为苍蝇之王。
Isn't that disgusting?
是不是很可怕?
So you begin to be under its control.
你就在它的控制之下。
And it can creep in and creep out, attacking and utilizing your flesh.
它自由地爬进爬出，使用你的肉体，你的血气。
Your flesh is now in partnership with them.
现在你的血气跟它同工。
And finally,
最终,
you have the last part is to destroy you.
你有最后一部分，就是来毁灭你的。
You look at that, it strips you out, it consumes you, eats you, everything what is left. Whatever is left, it will eat you up.
他把你撕裂了，把你吞吃了，你剩下的所有一切他都吃掉了。
They finish off everything, whatever that can be, they'll finish you and possess that person.
不管你里面有什么东西剩下的，他都吃掉了，最终完完全全的充满了你。
It become, instead of being filled with the Holy Spirit,
你没有，反而没有被圣灵充满。
You are filled. Because it keeps stripping out everything, you are like an empty shell. It can fill you fully, possess you fully.
它变成完全的充满你，因为它一直的使你里面倒空空洞。
You begin to be fully become a slave to the locusts.
然后你就完全的成为这个蚱蜢的、这个蝗虫的奴役。
You're taken over by them.
你被它完全充满了。
In the Bible, it says you can't repent anymore. You begin to agree. You begin to live according to the spirit, this demonic spirit.
圣经说你无法再悔改了，你开始按着这些邪灵的引领来活。
They don't regret. They don't feel remorseful anymore.
他们不再会觉得后悔还是悔改的。
So little, you see, the influence increases, the control increases.
所以你看，当这个影响增加，这个控制增加。
Finally, it wants to possess.
最终，他要充满你。
So even though this locust speaks of discipline and judgment,
即使这些蝗虫是说到审判管教,
it also the attributes and or characteristics also tells us the strategy of the enemy.
它的属性也告诉我们仇敌的策谋是什么。
If you recall when we did a study on the book of Revelation,
如果你记得我们查的那个启示录,
the fifth trumpet, there were also locusts.
第五号角的时候呢, 也有那个蝗虫释放。
But that locust is different. It's demonic. It was released from the pit of hell.
但那个蝗虫是不一样的，它是属邪灵的，它是从地狱的坑出来的。
It has all the features of all the ugly and demonic features.
它有各种, 魔鬼的,
that one, it cannot kill you, but it will torment you.
那个它不是来杀你,
if you don't, if you want to die, also cannot die.
你要死,
and that one clearly it says, don't touch those who have been sealed, who receive a seal from God.
那个蝗虫出来的时候, 清楚地说, 不可以触摸那些被神所应的百姓。
So we cannot just say, ah, this won't happen to me, this won't happen to Christians.
所以我们不可以随意地说, 哎呀, 这些不会发生在我身上, 不会发生在基督徒身上的。
We have to walk with God closely.
我们必须紧紧地与神同行。
We have to live an obedient life.
必须过一个顺服神的生命。
So question you ask me, oh, what happened now? I feel that I think I have chewing locusts in my life.
所以现在你说, 那怎么办呢? 我现在感觉, 我觉得我的生命中有这个在咀嚼我的蝗虫。
Praise the Lord.
赞美主,
wake up.
你醒过来了,
come back to God.
你要回到神这里,
humble yourself.
谦卑自己,
repent.
悔改,
don't let that chewing locust become swarming locust.
不要让这个咀嚼你的蝗虫成为一堆的, 一群的蝗虫。
At every stage you can come back to God. If you repent, God can restore you.
在每一阶段你都可以回到神面前, 如果你悔改神就能恢复你。
God wants to restore you.
因为神要恢复你。
God wants to restore all that has been stolen, all that has been killed and destroyed.
神要恢复你所有被偷窃的,被杀害,被毁灭的。
God gives that promise to King Solomon.
神给所罗门王这个应许。
We have a greater than King Solomon, we have Jesus.
我们有一个比所罗门王更伟大的,就是我们有耶稣。
Jesus died on the cross to break all these things.
耶稣为我们死在十架上,破除这些的咒诅。
He stretched off his hand and he said, come, grab my hand, come back to me, I can save you.
耶稣伸出他的手说, 抓住我的手, 来到我这里, 我能救你。
Beware of the locusts in the days of evil.
你要小心, 在邪恶的日子临到的蝗虫。
Stand firm,
要站稳,
trusting in God.
信靠神。
Don't have to be what everybody can do this, ma, everybody can do that, ma.
你不需要做, 每个人认为可以做的事情, 你说, 每个人都可以做这个, 每个人可以做那个。
We are not just purposely wanting to be different for the sake of being different.
当然我们不是故意要成为一个不一样的人, 为了成为独特的人。
We want to be God's people. Amen.
我们是为了要成为神的百姓。
Obey him.
顺服他。
Love him.
爱他。
Be who he wants us to be.
成为他要你成为的那个人。
Fulfill the destiny he has for you in this life.
成就他在这一生为你存留的天命。
Be conformed to be the image and likeness of Jesus.
被塑造成为效法基督的形象和样式。
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to close with an interesting thought.
我要以一个很有趣的思想来结束。
When we speak about locusts,
那我们说到蝗虫,
there is a very interesting person who eats locusts.
有一个很有趣的人, 他吃蝗虫。
Do you know in Leviticus,
你知道在利未记,
locusts are kosher food. That means halal, can eat one. Look, God allows his people to eat locusts.
蝗虫是属于 以色列人可以吃的食物,
clean, it's clean and you can eat.
属于洁净的食物, 神给他的百姓可以吃。
And it has a lot, it's very nutritious.
它还很有很多的营养。
Lots of protein.
蛋白质。
Some countries eat these locusts as delicacies or desserts.
有些国家把蝗虫当成是, 他们的独特的点心。
But don't laugh at this, because you have a servant of God who actually eat locusts.
因为有一个神的仆人, 他实在是在吃蝗虫的。
Matthew chapter 3,
马太福音第三章,
verse 4,
第四节,
John the Baptist, the prophet that was sent by God to prepare the way of the first coming of Jesus.
这约翰身穿骆驼毛的,
John the Baptist,
施洗约翰,
was sent by God to prepare the way for the first coming of Jesus.
神差他来, 来预备耶稣的第一次来临。
Let's read verse 4. Now John himself was clothed in camel's hair. He wears camel's hair. He has a leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey.
这约翰身穿骆驼毛的衣服, 腰束皮带, 吃的是蝗虫野蜜。
We have been studying the Elijah Remnant Company.
我们一直在查这个以利亚的剩余团队。
In the end times, God will release the spirit and power of Elijah.
在末日，神要释放以利亚的灵和能力。John
the Baptist was a type of spirit and power of Elijah.
施洗约翰就是一种的以利亚的灵和能力。
Like I said, you know, what power does he carry? Is it what he spoke cause people to come back and repent.
他带着怎样的能力, 就是他传讲的时候能够使人悔改, 回到神那里。
See, that is really powerful power.
这才是真正有能力的能力。
Of course, you can do signs, wonders, miracles, all these also power.
当然你可以做神迹, 其实这些也是能力。
But what did Peter do on the day of Pentecost?
但彼得在五旬节, 他做什么神迹呢?
The power that he demonstrated was he spoke and 3,000 was converted.
他彰显的能力就是他传讲的时候有3,000人悔改。
That was power from on high.
那就是从至高者来的能力。
So this John the Baptist was preparing the way for Jesus, first coming of Jesus.
所以这施洗约翰, 他就是在预备耶稣的
Those people were living in you know, all the hypocrisy of Pharisees and Sadducees.
那些周围的人, 他们都是假冒伪善的法利赛人、撒都该人。
And he said, come, repent.
他跟他们说, 来悔改。
Prepare the way of the Lord.
来预备主的道路。
The kingdom of God is near, repent.
神的天国近了悔改。
Yes, but that was a powerful ministry.
那是大有能力的指示。
Jesus himself said, this is very great prophet.
耶稣本身说, 这是伟大的先知。
John the Baptist was a great prophet.
他说施洗约翰是一个伟大的, 最伟大的先知。
But why did he eat locusts?
那为什么他吃蝗虫?
There can be many reasons.
可能可以有很多原因。
But I want to end our study tonight with this thought.
但我今天要以这个思想来结束我们的查经。
See, what in the Bible, what a person eats speaks a lot of things.
你看在圣经, 一个人吃什么, 就代表很多东西。
Remember Jesus?
你记得耶稣?
He was with a Samaritan woman.
当他与撒玛利亚妇人在一起。
And the disciples came, have you eaten anything?
这个门徒就来问他说, 你吃了东西没有?
My food, Jesus said, is to do the will of God.
耶稣说, 我的食物就是行神的旨意。
This is one angle when we see spiritual food.
这是一方面, 当我们怎么看待属灵的食物。
My food, Jesus said,
耶稣说, 我的食物,
is to do the will of God.
就是行父的旨意。
John the Baptist,
施洗约翰,
his will, his purpose, his destiny,
他的旨意, 他的天命, 他的目的,
is to prepare the way for Jesus.
就是来为耶稣预备道路。
The spirit and power of Elijah that is to come in the end times,
以利亚的灵和能力在末日要临到,
is to prepare for the second coming.
也是来预备耶稣的第二次再来。
That was the will given to John the Baptist.
这个意志, 这个旨意赐给施洗约翰。
The end times army also will have this destiny, prepare the world for the second coming of Jesus.
末日的军队也有这个旨意, 就是要预备这个道路给耶稣的第二次带来。
What kind of message will we speak as the end times company?
我们作为末日的团队, 我们传讲的是什么信息呢?
Let's learn from John the Baptist.
让我们从施洗约翰学习。
It's both locusts and wild honey.
他吃的是蝗虫和野蜜。
Locust speaks of judgment.
蝗虫代表审判,
warnings.
警告,
disciplines.
管教。
Honey speaks of blessing.
蜜糖, 野蜜代表祝福,
refreshing.
更新,
renewal.
更新,
enlightenment.
亮光。
God promised his people a land flowing with milk and honey.
神答应他的百姓的 土地是充满蜜与牛奶之地。
If we want to be a part of this end time remnant company,
如果我们要成为这个末日团队的一份子,
we must eat locusts and honey.
我们就必须吃这个蚂蚱、蚱蜢，还有这个蜜。
Too many people today know only how to preach honey messages.
今天太多的人, 他们只是懂得传讲蜜糖的信息。
Sugar-coated blessings and grace and blessing.
包着糖的祝福,
causing a lot of diabetes Christians.
使到基督徒,
diabetic Christians.
很多基督徒生了糖尿病。
And this is not what God wants.
这并不是神要的。
To prepare for the second coming, we need both honey and locusts. We must not be afraid to speak warnings.
你不可以感到害怕,
we cannot be fearful of men and not warn of the judgments to come.
你不可以惧怕人而不敢去警告人家将来临的审判。
Because if not, we are betraying God's purpose and destiny for our lives.
因为要不然我们就是在我们的生命中出卖了神的天命，神的旨意。
Let us eat locusts. That's the will of God for the end time remnant.
让我们吃这个蝗虫，这是神的旨意给末日的团队。
It is also not just always gloom and doom, dire judgment or dire judgment.
当然，你的信息也不是常常是灰暗、黑暗的，要死了，要审判了。
Oh, everybody will die, sin, die, judgment.
每个人都要死了，犯罪要死了。
There are also such preachers.
也是有这种的讲员。
John the Baptist ate locusts and honey.
施洗约翰他吃的是蝗虫还有蜜。
There is a new age coming.
有一个新的世纪要临到。
There is a new 1,000 millennial reign of the kingdom of God.
新的神的国度1000年的掌权要临到了。
We will rule with Jesus together.
我们要与耶稣一同掌权。
We will live with Jesus for eternity.
我们要与耶稣一起在永恒里生活。
That's the honey.
这就是蜜。
Whatever we leave here is temporal.
不管我们在这地上有的是什么，它是短暂的。
Don't sacrifice our future for the purpose of present.
不要为了今天而牺牲你的将来。
Your future is an eternity with God.
你的将来就是在永恒里与神同在。
Full of pleasure.
充满 这个欢乐,
joy,
喜乐,
unspeakable,
说不出的喜乐,
that's honey.
那就是蜜。
And then Jesus spoke of John the Baptist.
耶稣说到施洗约翰,
in Luke chapter 7,
在路加福音第七章,
John the Baptist came neither eating bread nor drinking wine. And you say he has a demon.
施洗约翰来不吃饼不喝酒，你们说他是被鬼附着的。
You see, John the Baptist
你看施洗约翰,
did not give himself to the luxury of his time.
他并没有去享受他当时的奢侈。
Jesus knew, you see, his food, his diet was very important.
耶稣知道他的胃口,他吃的东西是很重要的。
He died to self.
他对自己死。
He was a Nazarite.
他是一个纳西尔人。
He didn't drink wine. The wine speaks of what the world, the pleasures the world can give you.
他没有喝酒, 酒代表世界给你的享乐。
The bread, even what normal people would eat.
饼, 甚至是普通人也吃的饼。
He chose to eat locusts and honey.
他都没吃, 他拣选吃的是这个蝗虫和蜜。
A special calling calls for a special diet.
特别的呼召就需要特别的节制的胃口。
Amen.
Amen.
So I pray that this study tonight will be helpful to all of us.
所以我祷告今天的查经对每个人都有帮助。
We need to have a correct understanding of the locusts.
我们需要对蝗虫有正确的理解。There
will be locusts, waves of locusts in the near future.
在将来临的日子会有一波又一波的这个蝗虫。
Famine will hit the land, will hit the earth.
饥荒要击打全地。
What will happen then?
那会发生什么事呢?
Are we prepared? Will we be spared?
我们预备好了吗? 我们会被避免吗?
Will we be doing miracles of multiplication?
我们会在做这个使东西增多的神迹吗?
Will we be fearful?
还是我们会感到惧怕?
Let's gain the right perspective as we continue the study of Book of Joel.
当我们继续查约珥书的时候，让我们有正确的看法。
After Joel begins to prophesy, speak about this locust, he begins to show us what happened next.
在约珥说到这个蝗虫之后，他开始告诉我们接下来会发生的事情。
Let us pray. Father, we thank you for tonight.
天父，我们为今晚感谢你。
It's your grace and mercy that gives us this opportunity to study your word.
因为你的恩典怜悯给我们这个机会来查你的话语。
May your word brings enlightenment to every one of us.
愿你的话语使我们每个人有亮光。
May the entrance of your word brings light to our spirit, soul, and body.
愿你的亮光把光带给我们的灵和魂和身体。
Father, give us a balanced biblical understanding of your judgment.
天父使我们对你的审判有一个平衡的圣经的理解。
You love us.
你爱我们。
You want us to be free from the clutches of the locust.
你要我们脱离这个蝗虫的爪。
It is not your purpose for us to fall under the judgment of locusts.
这并不是你的旨意，要我们处在这个蝗虫的审判之中。
Help us.
求你帮助我们,
lead a life that is obedient to you.
过一个顺服你的生命,
loving you.
来爱你,
doing your will, O God.
行你的旨意。
Lord, raise up a generation.
主啊, 兴起这一团队。
Raise up a generation that knows how to eat locusts and honey.
兴起这一代懂得怎么吃 蝗虫和蜜。
Raise up an end time remnant company.
兴起这个末日的剩余的团队。
Help us, O God.
帮助我们。
Help us, O God. Every one of us.
每一个人。
We ask for your hand to be on every one of us.
我们祈求你的手在每个人身上。
From the youngest to the oldest.
从最年幼到最年老。
Stir, Holy Spirit, stir their hearts tonight.
圣灵，求你激动每一个人的心。
Stir and touch our hearts tonight.
求你来触摸我们的心。
Help us, Lord. Stir the spiritual desire.
激动起我们里面的属灵渴望。
Stir the spirit, the destiny within us.
激动在我们里面的天命。
Do these wonders, miracles, I pray.
在我们里面做这奇妙的神迹。
Stir, we ask in Jesus.
激动我们每一个人，我们求奉耶稣的名。
Thank you, Lord.
感谢你。
We ask and pray and all these in Jesus' name.
我们奉耶稣的名祷告，阿门。
Amen, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
赞美主。
Praise God.